गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन, आई एम कनिका एंड गिव यू सम कंटेंट अबाउट सेक्शन 144. इट इज इम्पोज्ड इन अ गिवन रीजन इन इमरजेंसी सिचुएशंस और केसेस ऑफ न्यूसेंस और परसीव्ड डेंजर ऑफ सम इवेंट दैट हैज अ पोटेंशियल टू क्रिएट अ ट्रबल सिचुएशन और डैमेज ऑफ ह्यूमन लाइव्स और प्रॉपर्टी. इन जनरल वी कैन से 144 पब्लिक ग्रैबिंग. व्हाट हैपेंस इन रीजंस देयर इमरजेंसी देयर इज सर्टेन क्राइटेरिया ऑफ डेंजर देन देयर पीपल विल नॉट गैदर पब्लिकली. They are not allowed. It is restricted. That's why Section 144 is implemented to the states. In the past, it was used to come when there was a need to implement certain restrictions in order to prevent the eruptions of some protest or riot can give to unrest. The executive magistrate of the given jurisdiction has been conferred to power to issue orders, and under Section 144, there is an independent emergency situation. Moving forward, of the provisions of Section 144, it also places restriction on handling or transporting any kind of weapon in the given jurisdiction where one Section 4 is imposed. जहाँ भी imposed हुआ है, वहाँ weapon use होगा, handle करेंगे transport. अगर कोई भी violation हुआ इस regard में, people doing it in any form can be detained, such as can punishment for 3 years. In order to pass the Section 144, it what will happen? There can be cannot be in any movement of the public. All education institutions in a given area will be remain closed for that a particular time. Holding any public meeting or conducting rallies in the area are banned due to the period of Section 144 in a force. In areas where Section 144 is applied and implemented, it is deemed that it is punishable to obstruct law enforcement agencies from disbanding unlawful assemblies. In case of any arising need, Section 144 also empowers the authority to stop interest in the religion. So, if we come forward to the last provision, it is the purpose, main purpose of the to maintain peace and order in the areas where trouble is erupted, to disturb the regular life. 144 CRPC covers the conducting of some events which are otherwise allowed during regular times. What is the duration and order of 144? In given jurisdiction, there is no order can remain in force for a period of more than 1 month. Under the state government's direction, it can choose to extend the validity to 2 or more months with the maximum validity to 6 months. Once the situation becomes normal, it can be withdrawn and it can be eliminated from the state of Section 144. Now, it is also authorized by the executive magistrate of any state and territory in order to prohibit the assembly in that area. It carried the restrict sort of weapon where it has imposed and detained violating it. What is the latest news? What is the section in latest news with the Section 144? Like currently, on September 17, 2020, restriction was imposed in the Mumbai for the Commissioner of Police, Greater Mumbai. These restrictions are imposed of underwriting the surge in coronavirus cases in the city. Mumbai has one of the affected areas of COVID-19 pandemic last year. On March 22, Delhi government also imposed Section 1 to stop the spread of coronavirus. It had claimed that 14,500 villages worldwide have affected over 30,000-40,000 people as the virus spreads in countries. It is an emergency, and it was an emergency last year also. Several states for Delhi government imposed Section 144 for local transmission of 19. But what is the different thing here? Last thing, what is different in curfew in Section 144? In curfew also we say that no one is allowed to stand together, be together, no one is allowed to, like lockdown, there is no one allowed to come together, go around, shop or anything. But what is different in Section 144 and curfew? In Section 144, it prohibits the gathering of 4 or more people in the concerned area where the eruption is being made. While during the curfew, people are instructed to stay indoors for a particular period of time. The government puts a complete restriction on traffic as well in the curfew. Markets, schools, colleges and office remain closed under the curfew, and the only essential services are right. So there are some criticism of this section, Section 144. It is too broad and words in section are wide enough to give absolute power to magistrate to be exercised jurisdictionally. Second, the immediate remedy against such an order is revocation of application to the magistrate himself. An aggrieved individual can approach the High Court filing a writ petition if we fundamental rights are stake. And however, fears are before ICO independence, ICO already infringed. What are the court rulings contained to section 141? There was a case, Dr. Ram Manohar Lohia case, 1967. Supreme Court held that no democracy can exist if public order is freely allowed to disturb by the section of citizens. The Supreme Court in other recent judgments said the section cannot be used to impose restrictions on fundamental rights of the assembly peacefully, but cannot be invoked as a tool to prevent the legitimate expression of opinion and grievance of exercise to democratic rights of the people. Morally, it is useful help to deal with the emergencies. However, absence of any narrow tailoring of wide executive powers with objective coupled with very limited judicial oversight over the executive branch makes the risks of abuse and misuse of the Section 144. Second, before the provision, the under section, magistrate should hold an inquiry and recall the urgency of the matter. If it is passed, then only it being done. There is need to balance the granting of plenary powers of the legislation to deal with the emergency situations and the need to protect the personal liberty and other freedom granted to the citizen under the fundamental rights of the constitution. Now, what are the punishments of section 144? Joining lawful assembly with armed weapons or deadly weapon. So, whoever being armed with any deadly weapon or with anything which is used as a weapon of office is likely to cause death is a member of unlawful assembly shall be punished with imprisonment of either description for a term which may extend to 2 years or a fine or a both. So, I hope you understood the topic and the punishment of section 144, which is very relevant these days and very also knowledgeable because it is a general topic currently going on all over the India. Thank you so much.